Today, in 15th group elements about ammonia. Already we know that ammonia preparations and structures. Ammonia, we know, it has sp3 hybridization, it has a pyramidal shape, its possible bond angle is 107.5 degrees. And also it has a 3 bond pairs and 1 lone pair. Ammonia sp3 hybridization, pyramidal shape, possible bond angle 107.5 degrees. It has 3 bond pairs and 1 lone pair. And also ammonia preparations completed. What are the ammonia preparation? Ammonia is prepared by the one is, you know that laboratory properties. Second one is cyanamides process, cyanamide process. Third one is Haber's process, ammonia preparation. Next one, ammonia is prepared by three methods. That is laboratory preparation, cyanamide process, Haber's process. In laboratory, ammonium chlorides with sodium hydroxide or calcium hydroxide can form ammonia. In cyanamide process, calcium carbide reaction with nitrogen, it can form CaCN2+C. That CaCN2+C is called nitroleum, you know it. It is very important commutative bit. This is called nitroleum. This C means graphite. This C means graphite. And Haber's process, ammonia preparation. You know that Haber's process, ammonia preparation, nitrogen reaction with hydrogen, it can form ammonia. That is Haber's process, ammonia preparation. Next one is physical properties of ammonia. Next topic in ammonia, physical properties of ammonia. At room temperature, generally ammonia is in gas state. It is a gas state, colorless gas. It is in gas state and it has a pungent smell. Pungent smell. It is a colorless gas at room temperature. It has a pungent smell. It converted, that gas is converted into liquid state at -33.3 centigrade. That gas is converted into liquid state at -33.3 centigrade, means very low temperature. Next one is, it is converted into crystal state, solid state, -77.7 centigrade. -77.7 centigrade. Ammonia is a gas, it is a colorless gas, it has a pungent smell. It is converted into liquid state at -33.3 centigrade and convert into solid state -77.7 centigrade. They are the physical properties of ammonia. Next one is chemical properties of ammonia. Chemical properties of ammonia. Ammonia reaction with many gas, many compounds. In that ammonia, first one, ammonia reaction with HCl, it can form ammonium chloride, NH4Cl, ammonium chloride. Next one is ammonia reaction with water, it can form ammonium hydroxide, NH4OH, ammonium hydroxide possible. Generally, compared to ammonia molecule, ammonium compounds, means ammonium hydroxides, more reactive compounds. So ammonium hydroxide, suppose you will take ammonium hydroxide. This ammonium hydroxide reaction with zinc sulfate, ZnSO4. Ammonium hydroxide reaction with zinc sulfate. It can form, you know that zinc combined to form zinc hydroxide, ammonia with sulfate, ammonium sulfate. means it can form zinc hydroxide ZnOH taken twice and ammonium sulfate NH4 taken twice SO4. Ammonium hydroxide reaction with zinc sulfate, zinc reaction with OH group, zinc hydroxide, ammonia reaction with sulfate group, ammonium sulfate. Generally this one has a white precipitate, it has a white precipitate. Next one, ammonium hydroxide, this ammonium hydroxide reaction with iron chloride, FeCl3, iron chloride. In that condition, it can form ammonia reaction with chlorine, it can form ammonium chloride. These are combined to form iron oxide with water molecule. So it can form Fe2O3.XH2O plus ammonium chloride. Fe2O3.XH2O and also ammonium chloride. Here remember, this ammonia reaction with chlorine, ammonium chloride, iron reaction with OH groups in excess, it can form iron oxide with XH2O. Means X means number of the water molecule, 1, 2, 3, any number possible. This one has a generally brown precipitate possible. It has a brown precipitate. Fe2O3.XH2O, it has a brown precipitate possible. Ammonia with HCl, ammonium chloride, ammonia with water molecule, ammonium hydroxide, chemical properties of ammonia. Ammonia with HCl, ammonium chloride, ammonia with water, ammonium hydroxide. Ammonium hydroxide with zinc sulfate, it can form zinc hydroxide, white precipitate compound. This is a white precipitate compound, white precipitate compound. Now, ammonium hydroxide reaction with iron chloride, it can form iron oxide with water molecule. This is a brown precipitate compound. This is a brown precipitate compound. That is the fourth property. Next one, means HCl, water, ammonia water, ammonium hydroxide. This compound's reaction with zinc sulfate and iron chloride, it can form white precipitate and brown precipitate. This is very important competitive bit. Remember the color. Remember the color. Fe2O3.XH2O, its color is brown precipitate. That is the, they are the chemical properties of iron oxide, sorry, ammonia. Some more chemical properties. Some more chemical properties of ammonia. Next one is ammonia. Ammonia reaction with Cu plus. Ammonia chemical properties, ammonia reaction with Cu plus 2, that is called copper, copper ion, blue color. It can form Cu NH3 taken 4 plus 2. Ammonia reaction with Cu NH3 plus 2, Cu plus 2 aqueous. This is also aqueous. This is 4 moles of ammonia. When reaction with Cu plus 2 aqueous, blue color, it can form Cu NH3 taken 4 plus 2. This is a deep blue color. Deep blue color. This is a blue color. This is a deep blue color. Ammonia with Cu plus 2. Cu plus 2 means maybe copper sulfate or copper chloride. So it can form copper ammonium compound. This is a complex compound. Square bracket compounds are called complex compound generally. It is a blue color. This is the deep blue color. That is another properties of ammonia. Next one is ammonia reaction with silver chloride. Silver chloride is generally white color. Silver chloride is white color. When it is react with ammonia, it can form AgNH3 taken twice Cl plus Cl minus ammonia. This is aqueous condition. This is aqueous. This is a colorless phosphor. Ammonia reaction with silver chloride. This silver reaction with 2 moles of ammonia plus and Cl minus is possible like this. So this is a AgCl is a white color. This is a colorless compound. This is a white color. This is a colorless compound. So these are the very important chemical properties of ammonia. Repeat once again. These two are very, very important chemical properties. Ammonia. Ammonia reaction with copper ions. It is a deep, blue color. It converts into its copper ammonium complex compound. It is a deep blue color. Ammonia reaction with AgCl. AgCl is a white compound. It can form silver ammonium compound. It is a colorless substance. They are the chemical properties of ammonia. Next one is how to calculate the ammonia identification test. Identification test. It is very, very important identification test of ammonia. Ammonia is identified by the Nessler's reagent. Nessler's reagent. Nessler's reagent formula K2HgI4. It is there in your practical plus 2 second year. Nessler's reagent. Ammonia, when reaction with Nessler's reagent, it can form brown precipitate. Very, very important competitive bit. Ammonia reaction with Nessler's reagent. What is the Nessler's reagent formula? K2HgI4. Formula, Nessler's reagent formula, K2HgI4. Ammonia reaction with Nessler's reagent, it can form a brown precipitate. It can form brown precipitate. You remember, they are the very important competitive bits. So that is about the ammonia. This is the identification test. Ammonia reaction with Nessler's reagent, it can form brown precipitate. So chemical properties of ammonia. Ammonia reaction with Cu plus 2, deep blue color. White precipitate, it is called colorless. Test, identification test of ammonia. It is reaction with K2HgI4, means Nessler's reagent. It can form brown precipitate. They are the chemical properties of ammonia. Next one, uses of ammonia. You know that what are the uses of ammonia. Ammonia generally used as a solvent. Ammonia used as a solvent. Ammonia uses of ammonia. Ammonia used as a solvent. Main one, water. Oh, ammonia used as a solvent. And also here another one is, this ammonia, when we observe this ammonia used for the fertilizers condition. It is used for the preparations of fertilizers. It is used for the preparation of fertilizers. Fertilizers means ammonium sulfate compounds, and also used the another one, urea compounds. Ammonium sulfates and urea. NH4 taken twice SO4. Ammonium sulfate and urea. Urea formula you know. NH2 taken twice CO. It is used as a solvent. Used for the preparation of fertilizers. Ammonium sulfate and urea. NH2 taken twice CO. Carbonyl group. It is called NH2CO. NH2, it is, you know, it is in your first year organic also. NH2CO. Next, another use is, it is used for the preparation of nitric acid, HNO3. Nitric acid preparation for the Ostwald's process. Ostwald's process, nitric acid preparation. Ammonia gas is used. Ostwald's process, nitric acid preparation, which one used? Ammonia is used. These are the main uses of ammonia. These are the main uses of ammonia. Used as a solvent, used in fertilizers like ammonium sulfate, urea, and also used in the preparation of nitric acid by the Ostwald's process. That is about ammonia. Next compound is nitrogen oxo acids. Nitrogen hydride ammonia completed. Nitrogen oxo acids. Nitrogen oxo acid, one of the acid is nitrous acid. You know that it is a nitrous acid. Nitrous acid formula HNO2. HNO2 is simple structure, N double bond O, H and day 2 bond. N double bond O, H and day 2 bond. This one. Two oxygens, one hydrogen. Or it is also written as, another structure N double bond O, OH. N double bond O, OH. Here, N double bond O, OH, NH double bond O, O. Generally, these two are called tautomerism compound. Why it is called tautomerism? Means hydrogen arrangement is changing. Here hydrogen is possible neighbor of the oxygen. Here it is possible by the neighbor of the hydrogen. Means this is also called tautomerism type structure. So that is the nitrous acid. Suppose when we observe this compound, in this compound nitrogen has a lone pair with OH group and double bond O. OH group and double bond. In this condition, nitrogen, you know, valency 5, 1, 2, 3 participating, one lone pair. Nitrogen has a one lone pair possible. And this compound, in this total compound, has a 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 sigma bonds possible. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, sorry, 1, 2, 3 sigma bonds possible. Another one is pi bond. In double bond, 1 sigma possible, 1 pi possible. So sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3 sigma bond, this one is a pi bond. So nitrogen has one lone pair. Oxygen has each oxygen 2 lone pairs, you know that. So how many oxygen in this? 2 oxygen. 2 to 0, 4 lone pairs on oxygen. On oxygen, how many lone pairs? 4 lone pairs. We know that nitrogen has one lone pair, oxygen has a 4 lone pair. Total number of lone pairs are 5 possible. Total number of bond, 3 sigma bond, 1 pi bond. Total number of bonds are 4 possible. That is called bond pairs. They are called bond pairs. Remember, very important. This structure is like angular shape. You know that it is like angular or V shape. Angular or V shape. How to prepare these nitrous acid? This nitrous acid is prepared by the several methods. One of the method is barium nitrite. BaNO2 taken into ice. BaNO2 taken into ice. When it is reaction with sulfuric acid, H2SO4. Barium with sulfate, barium sulfate. So it can form BaSO4. Remind one is NO2 with 2 hydrogen. So it can form 2 moles of nitrous acid. Barium with sulfate, barium sulfate, NO2 with 2 hydrogen, 2HNO2, 2 moles of hydrogen, 2 moles of NO2 group. So it can form this compound that is called nitrous acid. Nitrous acid preparation, one is barium nitrite with sulfuric acid, that is barium sulfate and nitrous acid. And that is the nitrous acid. Second condition, another one is in this, you know that dinitrogen trioxide, N2O3. Dinitrogen trioxide, N2O3 oxidation. N2O3 oxidation. It can form, N2O3 reaction with water. Nitrous oxide reaction with water. It can form HNO2. Reaction with water. Check it. 2 nitrogen, 2 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen. 3+1, 4 oxygen. Dinitrogen trioxide reaction with water. It can form nitrous acid. Nitrous acid is prepared by mainly two methods. What are they? Barium nitride reaction with sulfuric acid. Barium with SO4, barium sulfate. 2 hydrogen with nitride compound, HNO2, nitrous acid. Next, dinitrogen trioxide reaction with water. It can form nitrous acid. Third property, it is a weak acid. It is unstable compound. It is a weak acid and it is a unstable compound. And also, when we observed this nitrous acid, oxidation number is possibly as a 3, HNO2. In this HNO2, nitrogen oxidation number is plus 3. You know the method, hydrogen plus 1, nitrogen is X, you know method. 2 into oxygen minus 2 is equal to 0. 1 plus X minus 4 is equal to 0. X is equal plus 3. They are the nitrous acid properties. Nitrous acid is prepared by the barium nitrate with sulfuric acid, barium sulfate and nitrous acid. The nitrogen trioxide reaction with water, it can form nitrous acid. This is a weak acid. Its oxidation number is less than 5, that is plus 3. Weak acid, it is an unstable compound. That is about nitrous acid. This nitrous acid also dehydrating, it can form dinitrogen trioxide. You know that nitrous acid HNO2 dehydration, it can form N2O3 plus H2O. Dehydrating, it can form like that. Means it is a reversible reaction possible. Previous what we call N2O3 with water, nitrous acid. Now what we call it, dehydrating, means removal of water. Nitrous acid removal of water, it can form dinitrogen trioxide. That is about nitrous acid. Second one, another nitrogen compound is nitric acid. This is very important compound in nitrogen acids. In nitrogen acid, HNO3 is called nitric acid. It is also called aqua fortis. Aqua fortis means it is like water. But it is a strong acidic nature. In this HNO3, silver metal also dissolved. It is like water. HNO3, when we observed, it is like water. But its property is a strong properties. So that is how it is strong property, means when HNO3 add some amount of silver metal is added to HNO3, that silver metal is dissolved in HNO3. So that is called aqua fortis, means strong nature property, strong like water property. So they are called aqua fortis. It is a Latin word. So that is about nitric acid. Another name is aqua fortis. When we observe this nitric acid, this is a strong acid. It is a strong acidic nature, strong acid. Nitric acid is a strong acid. This nitric acid generally is prepared by the mainly two methods. One is Birkeland-Ide method. It is prepared by the two methods. वन इज बर्कलैंड आइड मेथड, सेकंड वन इज ऑस्टवाल्ड्स प्रोसेस, सेकंड वन इज ऑस्टवाल्ड्स प्रोसेस. नाइट्रिक एसिड इज प्रिपेयर्ड बाय मेनली टू मेथड्स. इट इज वन इज बर्कलैंड आइड मेथड, एनदर नेम इज इलेक्ट्रिक आर्क मेथड. इलेक्ट्रिक आर्क मेथड एनदर नेम इलेक्ट्रिक आर्क मेथड. सेकंड वन इज ऑस्टवाल्ड्स प्रोसेस. बाय दीज टू प्रोसेस नाइट्रिक एसिड इज प्रिपेयर्ड. इन दैट फर्स्ट वन इज बर्कलैंड आइड मेथड. ऑलरेडी यू नो नाइट्रिक एसिड, नाइट्रोजन ऑक्सो एसिड. इन दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एक्वा फॉरटिस, मीन्स इट इज ए स्ट्रांग एसिडिक नेचर कंपाउंड. इट इज लाइक वाटर, सो स्ट्रांग एसिड इट इज. दिस इज प्रिपेयर्ड बाय जनरली टू मेथड्स. वन इज बर्कलैंड आइड मेथड, सेकंड वन इज ऑस्टवाल्ड्स प्रोसेस. सो वॉट इज बर्कलैंड आइड मेथड? नाइट्रिक एसिड प्रिपरेशन, नाइट्रिक एसिड प्रिपरेशन. नाउ HNO3 nitric acid preparation. In that first one is Birkeland iodide process. One is Birkeland iodide process. It is also called electric arc method. Electric arc method. It is also called electric arc method. Very very important word. Why it is called electric arc method? It is also called electric arc method. Why it is called electric arc method? Means in this we applied the or supplied the electricity only, more amount of electricity. Generally this method is used where there is a electricity is available with very low cost. Very low cost available electricity where it is available with low cost. In that conditions only used Birkeland iodide method. In this Birkeland iodide methods, nitrogen reaction with oxygen, it can form nitric oxide gas. This nitrogen oxide reaction with oxygen, it can form nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen reaction with oxygen in presence of electric arc, it can form nitric oxide. This nitric oxide reaction with oxygen, nitrogen dioxide. This nitrogen dioxide oxidation under water, it can form nitric acid to HNO3. Balance it can form 2HNO3 nitric acid. 2 nitrogen 2 hydrogen 2 hydrogen 2 hydrogen, and also oxygen is 6 4 5 6 1 1 by 2 O2 or simply it is written as 4NO2 plus O2 plus 2H2O gives 4 moles of nitric acid. Anyone say 4 nitrogen 4 nitrogen 4 hydrogen 4 hydrogen, 4 2 is 8 plus 2 10 10 plus 2 12 oxygen, 4 3 is 12 oxygen. So this is the by electric arc method nitric acid is prepared. Where nitric acid Birkeland iodide method is used, the availability of electricity is very low cost, means very cheap cost. In that condition this Birkeland iodide method is used. How it is prepared? Nitrogen with oxygen, nitric oxide electric arc, nitric oxide with oxygen, nitrogen dioxide. Next nitrogen dioxide oxidation with water, it can form nitric acid. That is about the Birkeland iodide method nitric acid preparation. Second one is Ostwald's process. This is very important process in your competitive exams and also IP board exams. Ostwald's process or method. In this method, nitric acid is prepared by the ammonia compounds. It is prepared by the ammonia compound. In this diagram, this is the catalyst chamber. In this platinum catalyst used. This is the platinum catalyst. Platinum gas, it is called simply. Platinum gas. This is called catalyst chamber. Catalyst chamber. Its name, catalyst chamber. In this catalyst chamber, passed the nitro ammonia and oxygen gases. Ammonia and oxygen gases. Ammonia and oxygen gases. 1:7 or 1:8 ratio. Then this is passed into the aluminated tower. Passed into the aluminated tower. Passed into the aluminated tower. This is a aluminated tower or aluminium tower or chamber. In this, the substance are cooled it, cooling it. Cooling. In this, that substance are cooling, cool it. Then, this one is heated it, passed through the boiler. Passed through the boiler. In this boiler, this is the boiler. Then this is passed through the boiler. This is called boiler. Next, this one is passed into the oxidation chamber. Passed into the oxidation chamber. Oxidation chamber. This is the oxidation chamber. In this oxidation chamber, ammonia and oxygen gases are converted as a nitric oxide. Here, this oxidation chamber, nitric oxide reaction with oxygen, it can form nitrogen dioxide. Oxidation chamber. Oxidation chamber. Okay, now this is passed into the another container that is called absorption towers. This is passed into the absorption tower.
pass into the absorption tower. Water vapors possible here. Waste gases. This one waste gases outlet. Here there is a some bricks type compounds. Bricks adsorption, brick chamber also it is called. In this water drops fall in this one absorption by the these bricks, this one fall on the surface of this nitric oxide. This nitric oxide in that condition it is converted as nitric acid, HNO. Nitric acid. That is the Ostwald's process diagram. Repeat once again. It is very important competitive bit and IPE question also. So, in Ostwald's process, first we will take a catalyst chamber. This is called catalyst chamber. In this catalyst chamber, 1:7 or 1:8 ratio. Ammonia and oxygen gases passed into this catalyst chamber. Repeat once again. Ammonia and oxygen gases passed into this catalyst chamber with ratio 1:7 or 1:8 ratio. 1:7 or 1:8 ratio. When these gases are passed into this, in this there is a platinum catalyst. This is called platinum gauze. In there is a platinum catalyst. This platinum catalyst ammonia gas is passed into this, and then we cooling it at aluminium tower, then passed into the oxidation chamber through boiler. Means ammonia gases and oxygen gases, platinum gauze, boiler catalyst is used condition. This ammonia oxygen is converted as nitric oxide. This ammonia oxygen is converted as nitric oxide. That nitric oxide passes into this oxidation.